Hi guys, thank you for watching, and in this video we are going to cover the subassemblies. So subassemblies are assemblies of other assemblies. So as right now you can see, I have an assembly, so I'm gonna bring it to another assembly, so then it's gonna be a subassembly, and then I'm gonna show you how it works. Okay, so I have this assembly right now. So what I can do is I can just go here into the files, and then here you can see almost 7th or 8th option, which is make assemblies from assembly. So I'm just gonna select this make assembly from assembly, and then I need to choose the template. I am okay with the default template. Okay, so right now as you can see, we have already assembly, so this is option here. So if I'm gonna click the green check mark, then that assembly is gonna come over here in this assembly. Or if you want to have another assembly, so what you can do is you can go into browse, and then you can bring your assembly to this assembly. So this is already selected, so I'm just gonna click the green check mark. Okay, so right now that assembly comes into this assembly. So right now this is a sub assembly. Okay, so if I want to have a multiple subassembly, so as I already discussed in the previous video, what you can do is you can just hold the control key on your keyboard, and from the feature manager, what you can do is you can just bring the assemblies or part as much as you want. So I just want to have one more subassembly, I would say. And then again, I'm gonna press the control key on my keyboard, and then I'm gonna hold it and bring it to my assembly. Okay, so in this way I can have multiple subassemblies into my assembly. So there is another option which is working only for the parts. So what you can do is you can just hold the control key on your keyboard, and then you can just hold any part, whatever you want to make a copy, so like this. And in this way I can just copy my parts into assemblies if I want to have a multiple copies of any part. But if I'm gonna hold the control key and bring it to here, so it's gonna just bring this reddish part, not the whole assembly. So if you want to have a complete assembly, then what you need to do is you just need to go into feature manager, and you need to bring your assembly from here. And then there is one more thing. As you can see, this was my parent assembly, sub assembly, which I bring the first. So as you can see, there is a tiny F written down before the name. So because this is fixed with the origin of this assembly, and you can see the negative signs before the names of other sub assemblies and parts, because they are not fixed. Okay, and in the last video we already learned how we can fix them. Okay, the coolest thing about the subassembly is, like, if you want to modify your parent assembly, like parent subassembly, then it's gonna propagate to all other subassemblies as well. So for example, if I'm gonna modify, like if I'm gonna add some kind of washer here, so what I can do is I can just go into my parent subassembly, and then I can modify that. Okay, so let's go, and I would go into my first assembly from where I started. So what I can do is, like, I want to modify this. So as you can see, there is an option on the right side of your software. So file explorer, I'm gonna go into it, and then I am into the exercise file, and then I am into the 11th chapter 4th video. So this is the part, this is the part which I want to bring it here. So this is the quickest way, like, how you can access your parts or folder. So I'm just gonna hold this and bring it to here. So now what I want to do is I just want to bring it to here. So I'm just gonna select the inner side, and I'm gonna go into the mate, and then I want to have a mate between the outer side of this. If I am okay, I'm just gonna click the green check mark. Okay, so in this way I just created my first mate, but this is not enough. So what I want to do is I want to have one more mate from this surface to this surface, and it's gonna move there automatically. I am fine with it. I'm gonna click the green check mark. Okay, I'm fine with it. So as you can see, I just added a extra part, and I just modify my first assembly, which is the sub assembly in the newer assembly. So now, as I already mentioned, like, if we are gonna modify our first or parent sub assembly, so it will modify all other sub assemblies as well. So let's see, let's go into the Windows and then our main assembly. Look at that. So Like we just modify our parent subassembly and it automatically modified all our assemblies, as you can see here. So this is a really powerful tool, I would say. Like if you have to do something multiple times, so what you can do is you can just made it to a subassembly and then you can create subassemblies and then you can just modify your parent subassembly and it's gonna apply it to all of other subassemblies as well. So this is a really powerful tool in SolidWorks. So you should go into it, you should try into your designs. And in the next video, we are gonna learn how we can apply linear and circular patterns into assemblies. We need to have multiple patterns, so into the assembly, so how you can apply that. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, I am gonna highly recommend you, you can go into the description of this video where you can find my course link in which I have over 10 hours of videos in which I explain each and every command in a detailed way. Thank you.